Hey everyone, it's Daniel Badnell here for Fitness FAQs. Today I'm going to be showing you how to warm up your wrist. Now, especially if you're doing movements like handstands, it's absolutely essential to have the necessary range of motion to safely perform those skills. If you don't, your chance of getting injured is very high. Now, the wrist has several functions, including flexion, extension, radial and ulnar deviation, as well as when you pronate or supinate your forearm, the wrist joint is involved to a certain extent as well. This video is going to show you how to address all those motions of your wrist and ensure that you don't get injured with your practice. This first movement, keep both palms flat on the ground, elbows remain straight, oscillate in and out of N range, and you're going to feel this opening your wrists up into extension. Next movement, fingers facing towards the knees, once again elbows locked straight, oscillate back and forth in end range. You're going to feel this opening up your flexors and getting more range of motion into extension. With all these positions, guys, you want to go into some mild discomfort, but never as far into range where you experience pain. So just start off slow and progressively increase your range of motion over time. When it comes to how many repetitions on each of the movements you should be doing, I'd say as a general guideline, 10 to 15 would be the minimum that I'd want to do. But with that being said, I always find it's best to go by feel. What I mean by this is there's some days where it might take you just 15 reps to feel like you're warmed up and have enough range of motion in your wrists in a given position. There'll be other days when you're feeling stiffer, and it might take, say, 45 reps. So what I like to do is just get in the zone, feel my body warming up, and just focus on the training I'm about to do in the session, and don't concern myself with how many reps I'm doing. Just do as many as it takes for you to feel like you've got enough range of motion. Now, a commonly neglected aspect of warming up the wrists would have to be failing to stretch the fingers. So what we're doing here is we're leaning forward, raising up onto our fingers whilst keeping our elbows straight. Be gentle with this one, and as you get more advanced, you can lean forward to apply more pressure on the fingers and get a greater stretch. The other one is a similar movement, but you're rotating side to side whilst keeping your elbows straight. As I mentioned earlier, these wrist movements are all that you really need prior to training. They address all the different motions of the wrist. And in terms of giving a shout out to some of the people that have helped me understand wrist mobility and wrist stretches, thanks goes out to Kit Lawhon, Gold Medal Bodies, and Ido Portel. This one here is highly effective for opening up your extensor forearm muscles. So what you want to do, keep the elbows straight and grip your hands into a fist, trying to progressively grip tighter with each repetition. Finishing up with some rotations clockwise and anti-clockwise, and just a general shake out of your wrists, and you're ready for any training demands that you got coming up that day.
Now guys, I understand that these type of videos aren't the most exciting things to watch or apply, but the thing is, they're just as important, if not more, for the longevity of your training. So if you're staying injury free, you're gonna get ahead of other people who neglect this stuff, and you're gonna get stronger for it, okay? So don't just watch this video and then just forget about it. Consistently warm up your wrists prior to training to ensure you're injury free.
Thanks everyone for watching. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you like it to show your support. And I hope that this guide helps you stay injury free with your wrists. See you soon.